Hello everyone, this is Santiandoc2, and welcome to another mod overview. This time on Gadgetry, I'm doing the new update currently, and yeah. So, even though there's a bunch of new stuff, I thought I would cover things as if I haven't actually uploaded my previous attempt at this, which was last year or so. So I'm starting fresh with this one, going through everything here, as well as the new update. So to start with, you'll need a alloy furnace. Which means, oops, bricks, iron, furnace, clay, you get the idea. Otherwise though, you'll use this to make these two metals, as well as silicon. Silicon used to make a solar panel, as well as a bunch of other stuff with circuit. Then you've got the red metal for the energy side of things, powered furnace, solar panel, distiller. You get the idea. And then there's the steel, which is used for item related, as well as certain fluid or interaction blocks here and there. And then you use iron for fluids, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. So, that's a good thing to keep in mind. The main machines you'll be using, obviously, is a grinder, powered furnace, powered alloyer, and assembly press, which is obviously a water crafting table. The grinder, which if I can find it here... I didn't see this before, but it's not too bad. Dusts, ores, coal powder, basically. So doubler, as well as breaking stuff down as usual. This is the ore dictionary noticing there. Furnace, pretty standard. Obviously, alloyer, basically just a powered alloy furnace, you get the idea. So these will apply to that. The recipes are pretty simple though, with, for example, like the grinder, you get steel from your methods, or like so. Powder alloyer if you need it, powered furnace. The press though, as well as the circuits, being an auto crafting table, is pretty simple. But the one thing to consider about this mod is how you do use pipes and otherwise, because I've struggled to get the energy cell properly outputting things, but that's probably just me. So if you guys are able to ever get it going from one side to the other with the wrench, then that'd be great, because I struggle to do it for whatever reason. Especially when I put it there, so I just put that there as like a storage thing for whatever reason, instead of actually connecting to the machines, because I can't get it to work unless it's specifically sided, I'm not sure. Otherwise though, there is the furnace generator, pretty simple, as well as solar panel, which if I actually check, I've got coal, charcoal, and coal there. We've got 46,000, and probably even higher than the capacity this can go. So that is a good sign. I think you can interconnect energy cells, but I'm not too sure if everything is considered for throughout. No, it's only considered through the one. The solar panel's pretty simple. I don't know how much it outputs, but I'm pretty sure it's fairly minimal, and like maybe 4 or 8 or about as good as the generators, maybe a little, this furnace generator's maybe a bit worse. Then again, it's not too bad. The IOs are used for outputting specific things from a certain side. I struggle to use these sometimes, whether it be the power one, which is too bad, it can do that. So it can work, but it depends on how you use it. I assume you can use these just in case instead of the wrench, but the wrench probably might be helpful in configuring which sides are added or not. So you do that for outputting, that for inputting, I'm pretty sure, and then that's nothing. It's pretty simple. The pipes and nuggets, of course, that's pretty simple. Let's see, what have we got next? Sulfur's not, yeah. Biomass, smelts two items, distillery, which I'll look into soon. We've got the block breaker, block placer, and I've got an activator behind there. These won't break obsidian, which is interesting, but they'll break anything else in front of them. And I've got a cycle here to show that you can actually do that. Copper, stone, you get the idea. I've tried with levers, I can't get it working, and I think I've tried with redstone as well, but it doesn't make any difference, so I'd have to do that. You can actually place obsidian here, but this block placer only does the one, but I'm not sure if you actually have to configure a few things sometimes with the wrench when it comes to the sides for accepting or not accepting power, but either way you can place blocks multiple times with this. I don't know how high it goes, but it seems likely to go that high, so probably about 8 blocks I'd say, because I already placed 4, and about 5 or 6-ish. You can specify blocks, obviously. 2 broken. It didn't break the stone there, so that's obviously clear. Pretty simple. Activators. Pretty simple. Places. Tiers. You get the idea. Obviously these ones require power, and so on. I've got a farm set up here where I've got bone meal on this. I couldn't get the block breaker working, even where that yellow stained glass is, as well as over there. So I can do this, like so, and clearly the bone meal will be working. But I can't actually break it for whatever reason, either from the top or from the side, which I thought would have hit the hitbox of the plants before, but it seems unlikely. New things to this mod, obviously, are the sprinkler, we've got the range collector, oil well, drill and distiller, and everything else is pretty self-explanatory from the past versions, as well as block info there, which I skipped over, but strict one is probably what you're looking for. In terms of this combustion generators, knowing that how much is powered in each, I've got water and oil, giving 20,000, 50,000 with one water and refined fuel, I'm pretty sure, yeah. And ethanol provides that, which you also, I'm pretty sure, with the recipe you can find, like so. Pretty simple. When determining how to find oil in the world, you make an oil prospector, which you just hold in your hand, and it tells you the oil density. We've got 20-something here. We've got 73 with only just using solar panels to power this up, which gives you 73 there. But then if you go to certain others that are 80, I'm pretty sure this is, then you get 41. But if you find in 40, around 70. So I don't really know how the results determine. I assume either it's determined by power or it's determined by density, but the fact that I've got varying results shows I have no idea how it's based. The distillery obviously can make biomass as well as ethanol, with a variety of different things, as well as refined fuel with just oil, I'm pretty sure. And we've got a one-to-one of oil the pipe system into here. Do be careful with these buttons sometimes. I crashed on the combustion generator one a bit ago before recording, but just in case, some of these newer blocks will have this issue, and sometimes configuring these is a bit bizarre to me, so try your best with using the wrench probably in comparison to these buttons. Distillery recipe. We've got the sprinkler, which does that array, as you can see. And I'll show the drills in action in the next video. Thanks so much.